They would have said, you're so amazing, so how could you be so heartless, girl? Live your life, take T-I-M-E. Day and night just like Kid Cudi. You'll think of me, you will. Drake would say that you're the best he ever had. Rumors come and go, but you keep your shadow. Everywhere you go, it follows. Can't understand, I still love you.
Watch the drums talk about this
Hey everybody, it's me, I'm back, yes Roy Hardy, it's your boy Jezzo, and welcome back to another edition of the Jezzo Show. That's right, clap it up, I know you in your fucking seats like, yes, he is back. Okay, so yes, we've been gone for about a month, a little over a month, and a lot of you has hit me up on Facebook, Twitter, and even my show email to say, Zo, what the fuck is going on? Why you not on? And, you know, the rest goes on. You know. Okay, just briefly, I'm going to tell you why I was going. The reason why I was going, because I was going through some personal things. If you follow me on Facebook or Twitter, then you would know exactly what was going on. This is why I don't just promote Twitter and Facebook for nothing. You need to follow me so you can get the behind the scenes action of what's going on in my world. Okay, so I got into a little disagreement, a little argument with my mother. That's who I was actually staying with. And it was over my dogs, who has now passed on. Yes, my beloved Harlem, the one that you've seen in the video, a few videos back, he has passed on. It's a long story, I'll give it to you at another time on another show. But just to sum it up, I got into an argument about the dogs with my mother. We got into an argument about it, and I said argument about it too many times, right? Okay. And she kicked me out, basically. So now, I am staying at my boy Ty's house. As you can tell from my background and everything. I'm staying at my boy Ty's house, and you know, I'm just trying to get my shit together and get on my feet and possibly New Jersey. I'm coming out to you. Yes, I'm coming out to you. I got a new phone, the Motorola Droid. I still have my BlackBerry that I'm always talking about, but I have a new phone. Yes, the Motorola Droid is like one of like the hottest phones in the market right now. I don't know if you can see. It's like the hottest shit. But anyway, moving right along. Okay, so this past Thursday, I did an interview with one of the gay rappers. Yes, I have my first interview. I got my first interview popping, and baby, you're gonna see it. Okay, so I had my interview with a rapper by the name of J.R. He is self-proclaimed as the king of gay music. And honey, just to sum it up, he is sort of like the Little Kim, Foxy Brown-ish, Madonna-ish of gay music. Like, he pushes the envelope as far as he can push, honey. And the interview is so funny, it's wacky, it's crazy, it's out of order, it's everything that you love about Jezzo. And for it to be my first interview, I actually did kind of good. I think I did good. You know, as time goes on, I'm going to get better and better and better and better and better. But anyway, let's just catch up with some couple of things. Okay, so there's some things that I have not addressed, you know, that has taken place in pop culture. And, you know, we all missed it. Okay, Rihanna interview. As we know, Rihanna lied about a lot of things in her interview. And I knew that she was lying about a lot of things in her interview. You know, like, she never heard the song that Chris Brown had did for her. Basically, what actually happened, I think there was more to the story that both of them is leading on. I think that she provoked him in some kind of way that caused him to punch the shit out of her, which I don't condone. I don't condone violence against men, and I don't condone violence against women. You know what I'm saying? the Chris Brown interview. I think that Chris Brown, A, is being blackballed from the media. I think we all, not we, but I think the media, the industry as a whole, the fans, the viewers, whoever, leave Chris alone and let Chris repair his life. You know, he's young, he made a mistake, you know, he's said sorry countless times. I have an album, he said sorry many times on his album. Leave Chris alone, okay? Tiger Woods, ain't no good gonna ever come to Tiger Woods. 15 women, ain't no good gonna ever come to Tiger Woods. It's not. What he did was wrong, and it was just unjustifiable, and shame on you, Tiger Woods, okay? Now, I'm gonna throw it over to this clip of the interview that I did with JR, so I'll see
you. So I'm here with the king. Repeat again, the king of gay music, Mr. JR. Yes. Can we get a clap? A bump? Everybody, let's get a clap, please. Hello. Anyway, so what's going on, JR?
Nothing much, just in Chicago. I did the Album Music Awards.
Yes, I heard you shut it down.
I heard I did good. I think I did all right.
No. Over the top from what I heard. Yes, it was all over Twitter, it was all over Facebook, you shut it down.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
A lot of rappers in the gay industry was not there and they didn't
no,
shut
they
it
were.
Down. Well, they wasn't on stage. That's what I
Oh yeah, they were in the audience, they just wasn't on stage.
Right. So how was your experience being on stage?
It was good. I mean, the show was lengthy, but it was good. I enjoyed it. I mean, next year, hopefully, I'll get to do a whole set, you know, with dancers and everything, which is what I'm aiming for. So next year will probably be great.
What did you do after the award show? Did you go to like?
I went to the after party. The after party was hot. You will see it on the King of Game Music show. They had a pool inside the hotel, and it was like glass. It was just nice. It really was.
Did you get in the water?
I did not get in the water, but there was this one guy who got in the water. Who was hot. So, you know, you'll see all that. And then I met Rodney Chester. I took some pictures with him. I got a lot of offers to do movies. Shockingly, I got offers for a movie. All because of my little performance and a couple of magazines.
Cool. Okay, so just brief reviewers, who is JR?
Who is JR?
The JR Experience.
JR Experience.
Yes.
The Sasha Experience. No, I was just playing. JR is a young guy who started in 1999 with his first CD. 7 years late, I'm sorry, 11 years later, I'm down to 7 CDs. Doing it for the community, you know? That's what I'm doing.
Okay, your video, how do you come up with the concepts for your videos?
I know what means. They're juicy. I know what guys want to see.
Okay.
So I make sure that I understand that men are visual, so I make sure that they got nice visions to see. My job is to be the sexual part of the gay community. So
it's sexual. Oh, it is sexual. Oh, yes.
So when people tell me that they, I hear all the time from tons of people, even porn stars, that they like to do things to my
people. Like what?
Who was the guy?
Well, as we all seen, I got the video of me talking to Mr. Salt. He told me he's done it several times. Breon, Carlito, Giovanni, and everyone loves Giovanni.
I'm gonna get you a porn star talking to JR.
I'm mad because I'm here in New York and me and Carlito has been trying to meet up, but I have to leave tomorrow.
Really?
We came to Chicago, we missed each other, and I've been here, but we missed each other. This is stupid.
How was your experience in New York?
Cold.
Well, you should be used to it. You're from Chicago.
That's, yes, but it should not be cold here in New York.
Wait, stop. Stop the press.
It shouldn't be windy.
No. Stop the press. Because this shit that we got here right now is from New York. So don't even take
it. So I brought it with me?
Yes, you did. In order to find
it. Well, I had to bring the windy to show y'all that, you know, the king is in the house.
Okay. So let me ask you this. So what's going on with you and Brian? I'm gonna take it there. I mean, I had to, me and him talked over the phone, and I told him I wasn't
really
and stuff like that.
So what did he say on the phone?
No, I'm talking about you, me, oh. me. I didn't even have no bimbo on that. Who had the bimbo on that with the bimbo?
I thought you said you and him talked on the phone about it.
Anyway, hi, this is my residence from my job.
Yeah,
that was my residence from my job. But anyway, what you holding for? What you holding for? Anyway,
We talked about it. Okay, well, basically, the only thing I noticed is I released a song called Addicted to Me.
Okay.
And the song.
Excuse me, hold on. Sir, walk around.
You better work that shit, bitch.
No.
You better walk that shit, bitch.